God, command of Allah, submit to it. Forget about your forefather. Forget about your customs. Forget about your regions. These regional things, it's all invention. It's new thing. Before 70 years, I wasn't Pakistani, by the way. Likewise, you are, whatever region you are from. This nationalism, which we are bound to right now, and preferring it over Islam, over Allah, unfortunately, that when someone even reminding us that you are Muslim first, you are not Saudi first, or any other regional thing, national thing, we get upset. Subhanallah. And I was thinking, because I grew up away from my country of origin, where I was born, Pakistan. I grew up in Saudi Arabia. And I missed my land where I was born. And I studied about Pakistan a lot. I love my country, alhamdulillah. And I learned about it, that we took it for the name of Allah. Pakistan ka matlab kya? La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. This was our motto. Since the movement of Pakistan, what Pakistan stands for? La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And Allah the Almighty has given us this land. Now we turn nationalist. Just imagine. Come back to Allah. Come back to the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Come under the flag of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. That is my identity. That's how I clean my heart and get closer to Allah. Now, very briefly, according to Quran, there are three sources for me to know Allah and to get closer to Him. I told you, from His side, He is very close. But from this end, all the problem, all the issue. How I know Almighty God is close to me, is there for me. Number one, in Quran, Allah the Almighty said, look around. Look into my creation. And you will see the Creator. I'll give you example, a practical example. When you see a beautiful painting, you admire who? The painting or the painter? Subhanallah. That's what Allah the Almighty asking us. You want to know me and get closer to me? See my creations. Move around. Look around. You will see me. You will find me. You will find the Creator. This is one source, one way. Another one. Allah the Almighty starts sending His agents, His ambassadors, messengers, prophets to guide us, to teach us, to tell us who He is, the Almighty. So the easiest way to know Him is through His own kalam, through Quran, through the teaching of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Then there is a third way, the most obvious one. وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. Look inside of your own. And this is our topic today. Don't you see who is your Creator? How close He is to you? Who is running your life? The thing I started with, the moment He will pull the string, I'm done. People will start talking, oh, there was a person who used to give us khutbah. who used to lead Taraweeh, gone. So keep in mind, inside of my own, it's a mini universe, a small universe, run by Allah all the time. So these are three sources. Lead us to Allah. Make us aware of His existence, of His closeness. Always ponder about them for the sake of Allah. Then comes to one even more important point. The purpose of my creation. Allah the Almighty telling us in Quran in more than one place, repeatedly to emphasize every single creation in this universe is to serve you, O human. Let me repeat. Very important point. Every single creation of mine, that's what Almighty God telling us, it is to serve you, O human being. سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. Whatever on heavens, on earth, for you, to serve you, to accommodate you. And purpose of my creation, مَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونِي. I created you for myself, for my own, that you will choose me with your own choice. This is the whole test. That I have given you choices, now it's up to you. Do the right thing. Will you choose your Muhsin, the one who has all the favors on me from A to Z? Start counting this favor, this blessing from whom? This and this blessing from whom? Everything you have, you enjoy from whom? Who given you? Subhanallah. And then I prefer others over him. I neglect him. I turn my face away from him, from the one who is caretaker of my life, my well-being. So here, one thing, and I'll end with this, inshallah. Allah the Almighty said, everything you have, all the blessings you enjoy, you will be given without or with asking, except one, my own. You have to struggle for it. You have to take the initiative for it. You want me? You need to ask for it. فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. For me, you have to remember me first. In return, I will remember you. I will get closer to you. It's not given without asking, without struggle, without jihad. Bin nafs. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, and this is hadith Qudsi in Bukhari, إِن تَخَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي شِبْرًا تَخَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ بَاعًا. But again, the wording of the hadith, which Allah the Almighty is saying, when my man start getting closer to me, no matter that was a measurement of a hand, shibr, but he has to take the initiative and get closer. If he does that, I'll do the rest. I'll come to him for long. If he comes to me with the length of an arm, ذِرَاعًا تَقَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ بَاعًا, I'll come closer to him mile. If he comes to me walking, I'll receive him running. But the lesson here, I have to do it myself. Because the saying goes other way around. If he goes away from me, measurement of a hand, I'll neglect him as well, even more. Subhanallah, keep this in mind. So it is up to me right now whether choose to get closer to Allah or neglect Him. And if I neglect Him today, what would happen? نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَنَسِيَهُمْ الْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاهُمْ كَمَا نَسُوا لِقَاءَ يَوْمِهِمْ هَذَا. This is Kalam Allah, by the way, Quran. As they neglected us today, when the test is over at the day of judgment, we are going to neglect you. As you neglected the meeting of today, we are going to let you be neglected. So how we come closer to Allah? Few steps and we will go to second khutbah inshallah. And these are the conditions of getting closer to Allah. Salih alayhi salatu wasalam telling his people in Surah Hud, ayah number 61, فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ. Number one, seek forgiveness of your Lord. And that's what we need to do. ثُمَّ then تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ. Return to Him. Repent to Him. إِنَّ رَبِّي قَرِيب مُجِيب. Once you do this, you will find my Lord قَرِيب, the closest one to you. You will start realizing that. Mujib, answering every call you make. And one more thing to get closer to Allah, show your weakness before Allah. When you are specifically in sajda, Allah the Almighty said, wasjud waqtarib. Through sajda, through prostration, get even more closer. When you are in sajda, ask Allah, oh Allah, I need your qurb. I have spent all this life in heedlessness, in ghafla. Now, oh Allah, I am here asking and begging you to grant me your closeness. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us three things, and he used to ask this a lot. Oh Allah, I beg from you your ultimate love. Allahumma inni as'aluka hubbak. And ma'rifatak. I need to have your ma'rifah, to recognize you even more and more every day. And the third thing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to ask, Allahumma qarribni ilayka najiyya. Oh Allah, make me closer to you, najiyya, even more. That's the dua of